250 pounds, fighting out of Paris, France, Francis the Predator!
And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a wrestler, holding a professional record of 18 wins, 3 losses. He stands 64 inches tall, weighing in.
There you go, first round, you ready? You ready?
And we are underway. And he connects with the punch there. Ooh, blocks the shot. Opens with the left hand and lands flush. The kick is there to the body.
Caught him with a punch. Oh. He hurt him with that hook. Good defense there.
Effective use of the jab there by Francis Ngannou. How about that chin?
Oh! This could be it. Hard straight punch.
Blocks the shot.
Oh, big shot. Oh! This could be it right here. He's in big, big trouble.
Wow.
Hard hook.
Oh! The jab followed by the right hand. And now starting to snap off that jab. Throwing that jab yet again out of range.
Look at that, he's timing that jab. All of those are blocked. Oh, he's getting some hit from that one. Good combination so far from both men.
Oh, I know he's confident in his chin, Joe, but he left his head wide open for that returning hook there. He would be wise to start moving his feet, get on the tips of his toes, and figure out a way to get that head off the center.
Oh, he's tagging!
He's got him right here.
Gotta be careful there. Don't rush in. Body kick, look at that. Big punch. Hit him with some punches. Showing the punch.
Oh, big left hook there.
Oh, head kick. Oh, he got flipped there. He got hurt.
Miocic gets tattooed by that stiff jab.
That one hurt. Oh!
Timely defense there. Huge block for
big
him.
Big punches. 1-2. Huge uppercut misses.
Ngannou gets hit by that kick to the body.
Hard inside leg kick. Powerful jab.
Oh! Looked like it did stun him a little bit.
He's stumbling.
Just over 2 minutes to go in what has been a furious round one. 2 minutes now to go in round one. The Predator gets caught with that punch. Oh! Under 2 minutes to go in the round. Damaging strike there.
He tagged him again. He's hurt.
Well, he left his head open there, Joe, and he got cracked with that jab. He was almost moving into it. So let's see if he can switch up the footwork here, Joe, and make the requisite adjustments. Pretty strong jab.
Oh, he hurt him again. He is clearly in big, big trouble here.
Oh, a huge block there.
Fainting with the punch. Oh, head kick!
Goes down again. 45 seconds to go here in round one.
Oh, very nice.
The Predator gets stung by that leg kick.
Yeah, it's freaky. It's like he's cheating.
Oh, man. He's got him hurt here.
Oh, he's stunned again. Really threw a lot of power into that uppercut, but missed.
Oh, he might be out. Oh. And just like that, the fight is over.
Beautiful KO just as the round was ending.
Wow, Joe Rogan, you know, we see fighters all the time go for a takedown late in the round, but you don't see that every day. The flush knockout just before the final horn, the referee wisely jumping in to stop the fight. Gorgeous technique and a great job to catch the other guy when maybe he was thinking about the end of the round. Now he doesn't see it. Instead, he's staring up at the bright lights.
And here it is again. Crank right on the jaw.
Well, what a moment for this fighter here tonight. A massive knockout on the sport's biggest stage. Seminal moment for that fighter tonight. We go inside the octagon where Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Mario Yamasaki's called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 45 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Francis the Predator Ngannou.
All right, so congratulations to Francis Ngannou on another massive UFC win tonight. Very much looks the part of a guy who will one day be deemed the baddest man on the planet. Ngannou continues to chew up and spit out all comers as he ascends up this division. What a moment. What a fight.
Always give a game every time she me. Shoot blanks, but you gotta hit the chart at least. Seen a lot of young MCs even die for peace. Posting pictures while I'm posted in Belize. Spent those lonely rainy nights just praying on my knees. Being overseas is a daily routine. Young traveling the world, that's just been in our genes. Put the gang together, now you traumatized. Then Kofi's King Tut during Ramadan. Scramble like I'm number 9 during the summertime. Double them back number 1 and double back around. Drop DC4 and shut Atlantic down. 8 figure